Do you feel like when you go to matches or you are practicing serves, you end up missing so many serves to the net? Well, check out this video because I'm going to explain you exactly why is that happening, and I'm going to give you a tip that is going to give you way more net clearance, so next time you go play a match, you stop getting those serves to the net and you start winning more points because you are making way more serves in. Now, this video is going to give you way more net clearance, but if you are looking for more power in your serve, we created a free serve power course. It's on the first link on the description and the first comment, so go over there, click, register, it's absolutely free. It's actually four sections that are gonna help you out master the different parts of your serve, so this way you can start serving way harder and start winning more matches. So click, register, it's absolutely free, and we'll continue with the video. So the main thing that we're going to be talking about today is going to be about the left arm on the serve. Now you're going to be like, oh, but why are we talking about the left arm if I swing with the right arm? Well, the left arm makes a huge difference when we are analyzing someone's serve. And I'll explain you why. It keeps the balance of the body and it keeps the left shoulder a little bit higher. So what do I see most amateur players doing? They do either one of these two things. They either release the ball very early and they leave the left hand here super low, they never reach it up here. Okay, so if you see most players, most professional players, they toss the ball and the arm is all the way up extended. But you see so many amateur players, they release the ball very early when the ball is here and they leave the arm down here. But then I found out that there are also some players that they toss, the arm is perfect extended, but they bring it down right away. So what happens? If I toss and I bring my left arm down straight, what happens? I bring my whole body down and I tend to miss down and start framing balls, and look at me, I just framed a ball that I was trying to make actually, okay? So I bring my whole body down because my left shoulder is coming down with my arm, and I end up creating a bad angle with the point of contact and bringing the ball way too low, okay? So I use this tip all the time with all my students. As soon as they miss a few serves to the net, I only tell them to focus on one small thing, which is keeping the left arm longer up here after they toss the ball, okay? So it's as simple as tossing the ball, focusing only on keeping this left arm up here after you toss it, so it's gonna instantly keep your left shoulder higher. The point of contact is going to be up here with the arm fully straight instead of coming down, and it's going to have a way better angle with the net, okay? So you're going to try to toss the ball, keep your left hand up, and then serve it, okay? I'm going to do it again. You will see left arm up here, and then hear it, very good. So this is really forcing me to, from here, go upwards. Obviously, once I start the motion forward, my left arm is going to start coming down, but that's perfectly normal. What I don't want you to do is I don't want you to toss, bring it down right away, okay? So as soon as the racket starts the movement upwards, this arm is going to start coming down to again. It's kind of like counterbalance, okay? I'm coming up here, this one is coming down, but I don't want you to bring it down before you start moving up, okay? I was listening the other day to an interview that Maria Sharapova did, and she actually uses this tip when she gets stressed on matches. So what happens? When you get stressed, what do you feel? You feel like you start thinking about way too many things after you toss the ball, right? The thing that she focuses on is, she focuses on tossing and keeping the left arm up here. So if you keep your focus on the left arm, you can't be focusing on what are you doing with the right arm, and you will see that how instantly it's gonna help you improve the motion of your serve, stop thinking, and start making way more serves in, okay? So if you feel like you don't have that problem, but when you go to matches, you feel a little bit tight, which happens to everyone, it's perfectly normal, guys. Try this trick. It's gonna keep your mind away from the racket motion, and you will see how your racket is gonna be way more fluent and you're gonna start making way more serves in just because you're not thinking about it, okay? So, guys, I hope this tip helped you out. Like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and we'll see you in the next video. Now, the tip of this video is gonna really help you out go to a first link below, first comment, you have a free...